Today, I want to talk about the newly released TPS62903. This device can support wide input voltage range from 3 to 17 volts and step that input down to anything between 400 millivolts and 5.5 volts, with up to 3 amp of load. It can also support up to 150°C maximum junction temperature. First, I'd like to highlight the efficiency of this device at both heavy and light load conditions. At heavy load, the improved RDS(on) of the FET reduces the conduction losses of the device. At light load, the device benefits from its low quiescent current of 4 microamps. These enhancements combine to provide a boost in efficiency when compared to previous generation devices such as the TPS62130, where the RDS(on) and the quiescent current are higher. This figure shows a comparison between the two devices and clearly shows the TPS62903's superiority across all load conditions. We see about 2-3% of improvement in the 1-3 amp load range and 5-25% improvement for sub 1 milliamp load conditions. In addition to its great efficiency, the TPS62903 is a very flexible device. By using the device's smart configuration feature, the user has the option to select a forced PWM or auto PFM mode operation along with other features. In forced PWM mode, the switching frequency variation is well controlled and limited. This is good for noise filtering. However, there is a trade-off of lower efficiency when running this device in this mode. In auto mode, the switching frequency decreases linearly with the load, maintaining high efficiency at light load. This figure compares the efficiency between the two modes. At around 400 milliamps in a forced PWM mode, the efficiency drops drastically and reaches 10% around 10 milliamps. In auto mode, the efficiency is well maintained above 80%. The TPS62903 is also flexible enough to be optimized for space constraints applications. As shown in this board, the total application area can be as small as 25 millimeters square. This is possible by several thoughtful considerations that were part of the product development process. First and foremost, the device comes with a very small package that measures just 2.0 by 1.5 millimeters. Second, an internal feedback option has the potential to minimize the external component count and save both size and cost. Next, the TPS62903 can be configured to switch at either 2.5 MHz or 1 MHz. This allows the user to customize the inductor size to fit the needs of the application. And finally, only a single 10 microfarads input capacitor and a single 22 microfarads output capacitor are required. In this setup, I configured the device for internal feedback, which allows me to have system accuracy of better than 1% while saving bump costs since we don't have those external resistors. I set the input to 12 volts input and 1.2 V out, and I loaded it to around 3 amps. The scope plot shows the input voltage is very well stable and within 1% accuracy. Combining the high efficiency, small solution size, and 150°C junction temperature, the TPS62903 can provide the highest buck converter power density in the industry for nominal 12 volts input and 3 amp output. To learn more about this device, please visit ti.com/TPS62903. Thank you for watching.